هلا فرنس، تسكن كل يا مرجان كو آزاد هيدا باي يبدا لايتن كو جسك يا ماري بلو كن يوتيوب فيديو ان اپ کمنٹ سکتا ہوں اگر آپ کو ہمارا یہ موڈول اچھا لگا ہو تو پلیز چینل کو سبسکرائب کر لیں اور بیل آئیکن کو پریس کر کے آل پر سلیکٹ کر لیں تاکہ ایسی ویڈیو آپ کو روزانہ ملے اور پلیز اس ویڈیو کو لائک کر لیں
ٹو دی انٹر کنیکشن آف ویریس ڈیوائسز ٹو شیئر دیئر ریسورسز. A network is a group of devices connected to one another and allows exchange of data with each other. Cable networks, television networks, and telephone networks are examples of networks. A network ties things together. When we create a network of different devices, it is called networking. Computer network. A computer network is a collection of computers and peripheral devices, collectively known as network components, connected by communication links. In order to establish a computer network, we need at least two or more than two computers and some other devices. These devices are interconnected using a communication medium such as wire. The communication media or links allow the network components to work together. The network components may be located at remote locations or within the same building. Creating a computer network. A network can be of any size. For example, a small network can be created by connecting two computers for sharing files. A network can connect millions of computers to exchange information all over the world. The internet is the world's largest computer network. When you connect your computer to a network using a cable or other communication media, you become a network user and the computer becomes a workstation on the network. Your workstation has all its usual resources called local resources, such as a local hard drive and a local printer. Your workstation can also access files stored on a file server and make use of other network resources.
Remember, a file server is a computer connected to the network, which serves or distributes files to the network users. Network resources include disk storage space, printer, and other peripheral devices available.
Practical in computer lab. Visit the computer lab in your school and closely examine the computer network there. Prepare a list of the number of computers and other devices connected to the network.
Network benefits. Many companies and individuals have discovered that there are several benefits of connecting computers together.
Network can be benefit the users by increasing the lowering the costs and much more.
Ease of access. The network stores most central computer. Storing information on one or two central computers makes it easy for people to work with and manage their files. A network also allows to access their information from other computers on the network. Work from home. The network has that allow people to connect to the company's network using a modem. Once users are connected to the network, they can work with any data available on the network. Network makes it easy for access office information from home.
Sharing resources.
Computers connected to a network can share equipments and devices, including printers and hard drives. These equipments and devices resources. The ability to share resources reduces the cost of buying computer hardware. For example, instead of buying a printer for each person on a network, everyone on the network can share one central printer.
Sharing information.
You can use a network to exchange information with other people. Information can be in any form of data, such as documents created in a word processing program, or
information provided by a school database. Increase productivity.
Using the computers connected to a network, people can exchange information with one another.
When employees can easily access and exchange information, they can work more efficiently. For example, network allows people in different offices to work on a project together.
This also reduces the need for hard copies of all the documents.
Most of the people who are connected to a network use a central computer to work with different programs such as word processors and spreadsheets. Network makes installing programs simple because only one copy of a program needs to be installed on a central computer. Administration. Networking makes it easier to monitor and control the entire company's computers. Many companies have a person called the network administrator who oversees all administration for the network. Security. Before accessing information on a network, users must enter a username and password. This ensures that only authorized people can use the information stored on the network. Usernames and passwords allow the network administrator to keep track of everyone who uses the computers on the network. Networks have built-in security programs. These security programs monitor and report any abnormal activity on a computer network to the network administrator. Networks can be set up to refuse access to anyone who enters an incorrect password. This discourages unauthorized users from transmission on the network. Network hardware.
Network hardware includes the physical components that work together to create a network. All computer networks require at least the following hardware.
Computer. The most important job of a network is to link computers together. When computers are linked, the people using the computers can work more efficiently. Computers connected to a network need not be of the same type. Many networks contain different types of computers, such as IBM compatible and Macintosh.
Do you know special software are required to make different computers compatible with each other?
Cables. Cables are the wires that connect computers and resources on a network. Different kinds of cables can be used, depending on the type and size of the network.
The type of a cable used often determines the speed of the network, that is, how quickly the information travels through the network to reach its destination.
For some networks, several miles of cables may be required. Connectors. A connector is a device that joins two computers or networks together. Network interface card. A network interface card, NIC, is a device that joins a cable to a computer. Most network interface cards are installed inside a computer. The edge of the card can be seen at the back of the computer. A NIC has a port where the network cable plugs in.
Do you know? Nowadays, most of the computers are designed with pre-installed network interface card.
Most of the laptops come with inbuilt wireless network cards.
Types of networks. There are various types of computer networks. Generally, the following types of networks are used. Personal area network, PAN. A personal area network is a computer network used for communication among various electronic devices, such as personal computers, mobile phones in a close proximity. The area of a PAN is typically a few meters. PANs can be used for communication among the devices or for connecting to the internet. A PAN may use wireless connection as well.
Local Area Network, LAN. A local area network is the most common type of network. A LAN connects computers and devices located close to one another, such as in one building. Usually, this type of network does not consist of more than 100 computers. For example, computers connected in an office. Campus Area Network, CAN. A campus area network is a computer network made of an interconnection of two or more local area networks, LANs, within a limited area. This type of network is larger than a local area network, but smaller than wide area network, WAN.
Metropolitan Area Network, MAN. A metropolitan area network is also a collection of local area networks. Metropolitan Area Network connects computers located in the same geographical area, such as a city or town.
For example, branches of a local bank in a city.
Do you know, Campus Area Network can be considered as one of the forms of Metropolitan Area Network specific to an academic setting.
Wide Area Network, WAN.
A wide area network connects LAN and MAN together.
The networks that make up a wide area network may be located throughout a country or even around the world.
For example, internet and ATM facility.
When a single company owns and controls a wide area network, it is often called as an enterprise network. Nature of computer network, permanent network. Most companies use a permanent network to transfer information. A permanent network uses cables to link computers together. The computers and cables on a permanent network stay connected and in place at all times.
Temporary network. A temporary network is a network connection that is established for a brief period of time gets disconnected. The most common type of temporary network occurs when an employee connects a computer at home to a computer at the workplace using a modem.
Network topology. The art of connecting different computers in a network is known as topology.
The term network topology refers to the way in which the nodes, computer, or other devices that need to communicate of a network are linked together. It determines the data paths which may be used between any pair of nodes in the network. There are four basic topologies: star topology, ring topology, bus topology, mesh topology.
Star topology. All the nodes are connected to a central system called switch, which forwards data towards its final destination. The switch controls the communication on the network. Features of star topology.
It has minimal line cost.
If any of the local computer fails, the remaining portion of the network remains unaffected. Disadvantages of star topology. The system crucially depends on the central switch. If it fails, the entire network goes down. Ring topology. In a ring topology, the nodes are connected in a closed loop so that each device is connected to two other devices, one on either side. The computers in a ring topology are connected in the shape of a closed ring. Data travels only in one direction in a ring. Each computer passes the data to the next one on the line automatically. Advantages of ring topology.
It works well where there is no central site computer system.
It is more reliable than star topology. Disadvantages of ring topology.
It requires more complicated control software.
Failure of one node results in the failure of the entire network. Bus topology. In a bus topology, all the nodes are connected to a central cable called bus. In bus topology, a bus is a single continuous cable. Transmission from any node travels the length of the bus in both directions and can be received by all the other nodes in the network. The bus has terminators at either ends, which absorbs the signal, removing it from the bus. Advantages of bus topology.
It is quite easy to set up.
Failure of one node does not affect the rest of the network. Disadvantages of bus topology. It offers limited flexibility for change. A signal on the bus must be strong enough to reach the receiver.
Mesh topology. In a mesh topology, all the nodes are interconnected with one another, which allows each node to have a direct connection with all other nodes in the network. Advantages of mesh topology. Failure of one node does not affect the rest of network. Communication is very fast between any two nodes. Changes in the network can be done easily without interrupting other nodes. Disadvantages of mesh topology. It is the most expensive network as there are many redundant connections. Maintenance of this network is very difficult. Remember, a node is a computer or any other device on a network that communicates with other devices. The way in which the nodes of a network are linked together is called topology. Do you know, hubs are also used instead of switches to connect the computers. But switches are preferred more because of their better efficiency. Protocol. A network protocol defines rules for communication between network devices. Internet Protocol, IP. It is a protocol which is used to send data from one computer to another on the Internet. Each computer on the Internet has at least one IP address that uniquely identifies it from all other computers on the Internet. When you send or receive data, the message gets divided in the form of packets. These packets contain both the sender's and receiver's IP address. The Internet Protocol, Transmission Control Protocol, TCP. It is the protocol that puts the packets back in the right order. Hypertext Transfer Protocol, HTTP. It is a set of rules for transferring files, text, graphic images, sound, videos and other multimedia files on the World Wide Web. As soon as a user opens the web browser, the user is indirectly making use of the HTTP. HTTP is an application protocol that runs on top of the TCP or IP protocols. Do you know? Transmission Control Protocol and Internet Protocol are together known as TCP or IP. Wireless communication. Wireless means there is no physical path for the signals, data to move. Wireless communication is one of the biggest contributions to humankind. It involves sending and receiving information over a distance without using wires or cables. Let us learn about the most popular wireless communication technologies. Bluetooth. Bluetooth is a short-range wireless technology used for communication between devices. It was developed to exchange data between devices within a short range of about 10 meters of one another. It works even if there is a wall in between. For example, a Bluetooth-enabled phone will detect phones nearby and provide you a list of usernames. You can then send a message, photograph or movie to any username. Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi, wireless fidelity, is a popular technology that allows an electronic device to exchange wirelessly over a computer network. A Wi-Fi enabled device can connect to a network source such as the internet via a wireless network access point. An access point called hotspot can extend from an area as small as a few rooms to as large as many square miles. The communication systems. How to become bachelor's degree in computer science, information system or related field. Skills: time management, active listening, active learning, strong problem solving skills. Operating system. An operating system is a system software that acts as an interface between the user and the hardware. It is required to start and shut down the computer. It controls the various components of the computer system and also helps in sharing the resources. An operating system occupies the prime position between the hardware and the user. The user interacts with the system through an operating system. Functions of an operating system. An operating system provides a variety of services to your computer and its users. Some of the major functions of an operating system are program execution. It receives the commands from any application or system program, interprets it, and then executes it. Device management. Allocation and deallocation of all input and output devices are done by the operating system. It controls the working of all the devices connected to your computer. File management. It helps you to organize all data in files or folders and allocates space for files on secondary storage devices as and when required. It keeps track of the location of every file on the disk. Memory management. Memory is a major part of the computer system and dictates the speed of the operations. The main memory is thus managed by the operating system, ensuring the efficient functioning of your computer system. Types of operating system. There are different types of operating systems. They can be classified according to their functionality or the way they interact with the user. Let us learn about the types of operating systems based on user interaction. Character User Interface, CUI. This type of operating system requires the users to interact with the system by typing commands. Unix and DOS are the CUI-based operating systems. Graphical User Interface, GUI. This is popularly known as GUI, where the look of the operating system is graphic-oriented. The user can use a mouse to interact with the system by just clicking. If you have a touchscreen computer, you can use touch gestures like tap, press and hold, pinch, swipe, scroll, or rotate to interact with the system. Such operating systems are more popular than the CUI due to its ease of use. Windows and Linux are the most popular GUI-based operating systems. More fun in lab. Visit the computer lab of your school and notice which network topology is being used there for networking. Draw a diagram of the network including attached systems and devices. Key points. A network is a group of devices connected to one another. A computer network is a collection of computers and peripheral devices connected by communication links. A file server is a computer that distributes application programs and data files to the workstation. Your computer is a workstation on the network. A network can improve your work by increasing productivity, lowering the costs, and much more. The art of connecting different computers in a network is known as topology. A network can improve your work by increasing productivity, lowering the costs, and much more. A network protocol defines rules for communication between network devices. Wireless communication involves sending and receiving information over a distance without using wires or cables. Operating system acts as an interface between the user and the hardware.
Thank you, Ben.